In the previous lecture, we discussed difference between IGP protocols and EGP protocols. And this difference actually answers where routing protocol operates, either within autonomous system or between autonomous systems. And now let's answer the question how routing protocol operates. And there are two different types of routing protocols: distance vector routing protocol and link state routing protocol. And here you see examples of routing protocols that are distance vector and link state. BGP, EIGRP, and RIP are distance vector routing protocols. OSPF and IS-IS are examples of link state routing protocols. But what is the main difference between distance vector and link state routing protocols? Difference is in approach to exchange of the routing information and making decisions. Before looking at those points, let me give you following example. Let's suppose that you are driving a car on the road, and you see a sign near the road that tells you that New York City is to the right, you need to turn right, and distance to New York is, let's say, 100 miles. In this case, you know distance, 100 miles, and you know vector. You know that you need to turn right in order to get to New York. And it is analogy to distance vector routing protocols. Every router knows distance and knows direction. That's it. When you drive a car and you see such sign, you don't know whether there are some traffic jams, what is the weather forecast, what are other cities on the way to New York. You don't know anything about that. You just know distance. And you know vector. You need to turn right. That's all what you know. And now let's assume that you have a phone, and in the phone you entered a route to New York. And inside of the phone you see also traffic jams, you see all points on the way to New York, all villages, all small cities, everything. You know weather forecast, you know conditions, you know time, you know many, many different details. And this analogy applies to link state routing protocols. And it means that when you know more information, you could make decisions more wisely. And it means that you don't simply rely and trust sign and the road. Instead, you make decisions on your own. You select the best path to destination, because you know more about all different alternative ways how to reach New York City. And now let's discuss characteristics of distance vector routing protocols and link state routing protocols. In distance vector routing protocol, routers send information about their directly connected networks to their neighbors, only to the neighbors. Let's suppose that a specific router has three different neighbors that are directly connected to it. It means that in distance vector routing protocol, this router will send information about its directly connected networks only to those three routers. That's it. Next, every router selects best routes from the perspective of the neighbor. It means that when a specific router receives information about some remote network from neighbor router, then it will rely on this information and it will simply know that this specific network is accessible via this neighbor. That's it. And that's how this router will make selection of the best route. It will rely on the information received from the neighbor, similarly as you rely on information that you see on the sign on the road. Next point. Distance vector routing protocols have slow convergence. What is convergence? Convergence happens when a specific network disappears or appears. For example, on a specific router in some place in computer network, specific interface goes down. It means that corresponding directly connected route disappears from its routing table. And it means that if this route was advertised via any routing protocol to its neighbors, this router needs to send update and tell them that this specific network is no longer accessible. And when all other routers in the network in the autonomous system will receive this update, we could say that network has converged. It means that now all routers have consistent information. Similar example, when specific network appears, when for example specific interface on the router goes up. then this router needs to send information about this network to other neighbors. Those neighbors must send information to other neighbors, and so on and so forth, until network will be converged again. In distance vector routing protocols, convergence is slower than in link state routing protocols, because updates are sent from one neighbor to another, from another to another, and so on and so forth. Next point. In distance vector routing protocols, routers utilize less CPU and memory in comparison to link state routing protocols. They need to keep less information than in link state routing protocols. They actually get information only about routes and the metrics from their neighbors, and after that they simply need to select best route, and that's it. Best routes are inserted into the routing table. And all routes actually are stored in the routing database, and routing database is usually larger than routing table itself. And also, distance vector routing protocols are prone to errors and loops, for example. And this may happen when routing tables are inconsistent and when specific updates were not yet received by some routers, and they may still route packets to some destinations that are already inaccessible, that are down. And this may very easily happen in distance vector routing protocols. Alright, let's now discuss characteristics of link state routing protocols. Here, routers send information about their links to all routers in the autonomous system. That is the main difference from distance vector routing protocols. It means that a specific router may tell all other routers in the autonomous system, hey, here are my three links. Here is IP address and mask for every link on my router. And this information is transmitted via all neighbors to all other routers in the autonomous system. And now, when all routers receive information about all links in the autonomous system on other routers, they may make decisions on their own. They select best routes to every single destination network, keeping all information about all links in the autonomous system in their memory. And of course, in such case, convergence will be much faster, because when specific network goes down, specific router will quickly send small update to all neighbors, they will replicate this update to their neighbors, and so on, and convergence will happen much faster. But of course, if routers keep all those details in their memories, they require higher CPU and memory resources. And of course, all computations are made in memory of the routers, that also takes resources. But certainly, link state routing protocols are very reliable, and they are less prone to any routing errors in comparison to distance vector routing protocols. The most popular link state routing protocol is OSPF. It is open source and it is available on any routers of any vendors. It is really nice protocol, but unfortunately it didn't become popular. And also, very important notice, all those mentioned protocols here are capable of exchange of IP version 4 prefixes and IP version 6 prefixes. For some protocols, there are different versions of the protocol that actually work with different protocols on network layer, I mean IP version 4 or IP version 6. Alright, that is the difference between distance vector and link state routing protocols. Link state is more sophisticated, and most popular choice here is OSPF. OSPF is basically most popular protocol that is used inside of the autonomous system, it is IGP protocol. But of course, you could also utilize distance vector routing protocol, and the most popular protocol for EGP connections is basically BGP protocol, that's just single choice. And now my question to you. Why BGP is actually distance vector routing protocol? Why it is not link state? Answer is following. As you already know, there are many different autonomous systems in the world. Basically, every organization that has specific public IP addresses ranges assigned to it could claim and get ASN number. And now, routing tables on core routers, BGP routers, are very large, and quantity of the routes, BGP routes, is close to 1 million. And this means that BGP routers need to utilize many memory resources in order to just keep this BGP routing table in memory. It is very hard. And if BGP was link state routing protocol, then all these BGP routers would keep in memory all information about all links of all BGP routers in the world. This information is very, very huge. And there is no such kind of router in the world that would be able to keep all this data in memory and make decisions on its own, make selections of best routes to destination networks. That's why BGP is distance vector protocol. And it means that in BGP, every router sends BGP prefixes with masks and metrics to all neighbors, and those neighbors make selections of best routes based on information received from neighbors. Alright, that's all for this lecture where we compared distance vector and link state routing protocols. Most popular link state routing protocol is OSPF, it is IGP protocol, and most popular distance vector protocol is BGP. It is EGP protocol, and it is used in order to exchange routing information between autonomous systems. Great. Next, let me tell you which networks are blocked in BGP. I'll see you guys next.